Hello, everyone. I'm Don Caywood, pastor of Odessa Christian Faith Center, and it's great to be with you today. What I'm going to share with you is exiting your year and entering into your brand new year. Do you know that life, every single day, our life is a series of exiting and entering? For instance, when you wake up in the morning, what do? You exit your bed, you go into the bathroom, you clean yourself, you exit the bathroom, you go into the kitchen, you eat your breakfast, you exit the kitchen, you go out into the garage, you enter into your car, and then you exit out of the garage, and then you drive to your place of employment, you exit out of your car, and you enter into your place of employment. And I could just go on and on and on. Everything in life is about exiting or leaving and entering. And here we have a verse in Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 23. Then he, that's God, brought us, that's the Israelites, out from there. There here is Egypt. And Egypt is just a type of the world. It's a type of the world system. So then he, God, brought us out from there that he might bring us in. He brought us into where? The land of promise for the Israelites, Canaan land. He brought us in to give us the land which he swore unto our fathers. And so as we exit this year and enter into a new year, there's just several things I want to share with you today that I believe are relevant. I don't want to give you a long list of things to do or not to do, just several things that I believe are relevant for exiting or leaving our year successfully and going into our brand new year. The first thing that I would encourage you to do is, as you're exiting this year, review the year. Look back at your year, and first of all, look at the challenges you had. Look at the failures you had. Look at the situations that you were not able to overcome. Now, that being said, let me say this to you. I believe that failures are an opportunity to learn. The last thing we want to do is look at our challenges that we did not overcome, look at our failures, and condemn ourselves and make ourselves feel all guilty and ashamed. You don't want to do that. No, every challenge in life, even if you have yet to meet that challenge, is just an opportunity to learn something. So when you're reviewing any challenge that you did not meet successfully, what did you learn from it? How could you have handled it differently? What did God teach you while you were involved in that challenge? And then as you do that, and this is crucial, let go of that failure. Before you enter in your new year, let go of that failure. Again, don't let it stay with you. Don't allow it to conjure up regrets and all kinds of bad memories about what you went through. No, just learn from it and then let it go. And then the next thing you want to do is you want to review your victories. What were the good things that took place in your life in the current year? What did you learn about those victories? What kind of growth did you have in those victories? Because everything in life, remember, is exiting or leaving and entering. And in between exiting or leaving and entering, you're going to have crisis. Everything in life is a crisis. And so out of all those crises between leaving and entering, what did you learn in those victories that you overcame those crises in life? Was it a marital crisis? Was it an employment crisis? Was it a physical crisis, a financial crisis? What was it that God gave you victory, that God gave you some insight in how to successfully overcome that challenge in life? And just enjoy that moment of reliving how God got you through that situation. Just enjoy the presence of God as you're just remembering in your soul what God did for you, or what God did for you, or what God did through you. And then the next thing you want to do as you enter your new year, you want to pray. You know, prayer is crucial for our lives as children of God. If you are a child of God, it's crucial that we learn to seek out God and His wisdom each and every day, especially as you're leaving a year and entering into a new year. Now, here's something that when you pray, as you enter into your new year, again, this is something that is very, very crucial, and that is that you forgive. When you pray, ask God, is there anyone in my life right now that has offended me or hurt me, harmed me, wounded me, that I haven't let that go? Ask God. He will give you the right information. He'll bring that person or persons to your mind so that you can forgive them. Because if you don't forgive, you're going to find a closed heaven over that relationship. Maybe it's a fellow employee, maybe who's been jabbing at you, someone maybe who's been criticizing you, and maybe that person is an unbeliever. Well, if you hold unforgiveness towards that person, there's going to be an open, closed heaven over you and that person. You'll not be able to witness Christ to that person. So you want to forgive them. And then the next thing that you want to do after you forgive is ask God for His vision for your life for the coming year. What does God have for you? Where does God want to take you? You know, the Bible says in Proverbs 29:18, where there is no vision, people perish. You have to have a vision for life. You have to have a preferred future condition. That's what gives us hope. The word hope from the Bible literally means a confident and joyful expectation of God's goodness coming into your life. So what is that preferred future condition for your life in the coming year? What are your desires? What are your wants? What would you like to see take place in your life or in your marriage or in your physical status or your financial status or for your children? What do you want to see improvement in? What do you want to see the challenges that you have had in the past that maybe you have not overcome? What do you need to be able to overcome them? What's that vision? What's that word from God that you need in the coming year to overcome that particular challenge in your life? God has vision. You know, I learned a long time ago that the third person of the Godhead, who is the Holy Spirit, who comes and takes up residence in every believer, He has a language. You know what that language is? It's the language of dreams and visions. He loves to give God's dreams and visions to your life. So when you're praying, just ask God, what's the vision for the coming year? Now, He will work inside those dreams that the Holy Spirit has already put into your life. He will work inside those desires and those wants that you already have in your life. And along with that, while you're praying and asking God for a vision for the coming year, ask God for a fresh anointing in your life. Ask Him for that fresh touch in your life for the coming year. And that being said, the next thing I want to say to you as you enter your new year, make a decision that in the past, if you have limited God, you're going to stop that. You're going to stop limiting God, and you're going to make a decision coming into the new year that God is going to be your source of supply in every single area of your life. That by trusting God and by resting in the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ, you're going to believe that God is going to be your source for your spiritual food, your physical food, your financial food, your marital food, your relational food, all the food of your life, all the needs of your life. You're going to trust God 100% in the coming year for His supply to come and to meet each and every need of your life. And if you'll do that, I promise you it will make a difference because you're having God's vision in your heart, God's vision in your mind, in your soul. and then God is taking you in your spirit and into your heart, into a place where you have complete and total assurance, complete and total confidence. And then the last thing, as you have done all these simple things, as you enter the year, just give God praise. Give God thanksgiving. Maybe exit and enter your new year by taking communion and worshiping the Lord Jesus Christ, thanking Jesus for his broken body, thanking Jesus for his shed blood, praising God, worshiping God, entering into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. And I believe if you'll just do some of these simple things, understanding that exiting or leaving and entering, it's normal to life. It's normal to everyday living. And if you'll just do some of these simple things in your life, I believe that you will exit this year correctly and you will enter into your new year the right way with a great attitude, knowing and believing that if God be for you, who can be against you? It's been a pleasure to be with you today. God bless you. I look forward to talking to you again very, very soon.